Hello friends, in this video, let us discuss about the speed control of DC shunt motor. So if you understand the definition of speed control, the speed control can be defined as a intentional change in the drive speed or the shaft speed to a certain value in order to achieve a certain specific process. Here, we are intentionally changing the speed control, and the speed control can be done either manually by an operator or by using some automatic control device. So if we distinguish the speed regulation and the speed control, the speed regulation is a natural change in speed of the shaft due to application of load on the shaft. But here we are intentionally changing the speed to achieve some specific work process, but in the speed regulation it automatically or unintentionally or naturally changes the speed due to the application of load on the shaft. So if we write the EMF equation of a DC motor, so generally EMF will be equal to P phi NZ upon 60A, where P is the number of poles, phi is the flux per pole, and N is the rotation of, that is the speed of rotation of motor in RPM, that is rotation per minute, and Z is the total number of conductors, A is the, that is the total number of armature conductors, A is the number of parallel paths. So I am rewriting this equation as E is equal to K into N phi, where K is given by Pz upon 60A. As we know that the poles of the motor are fixed and the total number of armature conductors once inserted are fixed and the number of parallel paths are fixed. So as these fixed quantities, I am representing them by a constant term, that is K. Now from here, if I write N, that is the speed, as a subject of formula, then N is equal to E upon K phi, and from the, if I draw the basic motor circuit, so basic DC motor circuit, if I say this is my V is the applied voltage, this is the armature resistance, this is I is the current flowing here, and here I am having the back EMF EB. So from here you can write your V is equal to E minus, that is E plus IARA, where E is nothing but V minus IARA upon K phi. Now by looking at the right hand side of, by looking at the quantities at the right hand side of this equation, I can see V minus IARA upon K phi. That means by varying or by changing these quantities, I can able to change the speed of my motor. So by changing the armature terminal voltage, I can vary the speed, and by changing the external resistance, I can change the speed, and by changing the flux per pole, I can change the speed. So but the first two changes are, that is the change in armature voltage and the change in the external resistance, it involves the change that affects the armature circuit, whereas the flux, changing flux per pole affects your field circuit. Therefore we have distinguished as armature control methods and the field control methods for the speed control of DC shunt motor or any DC motor. These methods can be applicable to your DC series motor, DC shunt motor or DC compound motors. So first of all, let us discuss the field control methods, where we are having the field rheostat method, and other one is the field control, that is the field voltage control method, and other one is also reluctance control method, where we are not discussing it here. Basically it is the designing of the mechanical features of the motor, where you can vary the reluctance, thereby you can vary the flux, and thereby you can change the speed. But here we are not going to discuss it exclusively. Let us discuss the field rheostat method and the field voltage control method. So if I draw the circuit diagram for the field rheostat method, this is the basic circuit diagram, where here your V is the applied voltage and this is the variable resistance, and from here we have tabbed it to the shunt field. This is my shunt field, and this is your armature, these are your brushes. So here what I do is, by increasing the value of this resistance, what I do is, I will reduce the current flowing in this field winding. I know that the phi is proportional to I. So as I have reduced the current flowing in this field winding by increasing the value of this variable resistance or the variable resistance of the field rheostat. Thereby, I can reduce the current, and by reducing the current, I am going to reduce the flux. But I know that from this equation, I can write my n is inversely proportional to phi. So by reducing the value of phi, I am going to increase the speed of motor. So by reducing the value of phi, I am able to increase the speed of motor, and generally a very small current flows through this field rheostat, and as very small current flows through this field rheostat, the power wasted is not too serious. So we are not troubled about the power wasted, and this method is very simple, very cheap, economic, and generally this finds a greater acceptance in the application of speed control in the DC motors. So the power wasted is negligible or not too serious, and if we discuss the drawbacks or the limitations, here the flux is only reduced, but the flux is not increased. So as the flux is only reduced, that means you can reduce the flux by increasing the value of the resistance. By increasing the value of resistance, you are going to reduce the current through this field winding, and thereby flux is reduced, and as flux is reduced, the speed is increased. You can say this is a drawback or the limitation. And if you discuss the certain other drawbacks, so here the limitation and the drawback, one is your creeping speeds cannot be obtained. Creeping speeds cannot be obtained. Creeping means very small speeds. Small or crawling speeds cannot be obtained. And the other thing is the top speeds are obtained at reduced torque owing to weak field. So the top speeds are obtained only at the reduced torque, which is owing to very weak field. So as we have seen, if I want to achieve a very top speed, then I should have a very weak field. So by having a very weak field, then only I am going to increase the top speeds. Now, at the advantage of getting top speed for the increased power output, because you know the power output EB into IA, where EB which depends on the speed. So from here you can see speed. Now as you increase the speed, your EB increases, therefore you will be having the increased output. So but at the advantage of increasing the output at high speed, I cannot compromise or trade off with the reduced torque. So I should obtain a good value of torque at a good value of output, but I cannot sacrifice my torque at very top speeds. And the third thing is, the third disadvantage you can notice here is, so the top speeds can be obtained at a reduced value of flux, and it is all due to the demagnetization effect on the field. So demagnetization on the field, and this is due to the armature reaction we have seen in the DC motors armature reaction, where we have seen the demagnetization effect on the field, which reduces the field flux, or you can say at the very weak field which is achieved at the top speed only. Now due to this very weak field, it causes the armature current to increase to achieve a certain load torque. Now as we are having a condition, or as we are having a situation of a very weak field, and that very weak field causes the armature current to increase to achieve a certain load torque, and this increased armature current may damage the armature windings, or it may cause instability, or it may cause the commutation problems. And also at the high speeds, we have to consider the mechanical features, because at high speeds you may know that the centrifugal forces act and which can damage the armature. So basically these are the limitations of this method. Now coming to the field voltage control method, here a separate variable voltage source is connected to the field apart from the main supply connected across the armature. So here I am having a separate voltage source which is connected only to the field winding, apart from a separate main, apart from the main supply voltage which is connected to the armature. So by varying the voltage of this separate voltage source, separate variable voltage source, I can vary the field flux. And generally here, if I have a AC supply, then I can use a electronic rectifier, which is you can use a three phase bridge configuration. So by using the electronic rectifier configuration, I can able to vary the output voltage, therefore you can able to vary the field flux, and thereby you can increase the speed of the motor. This is about the field control methods of the DC shunt motor. Now let us discuss the armature control methods. And one thing I forgot to say in the field rheostat control method. So here, as we are playing only with the shunt field branch and we are not playing with the armature, this method of speed control can be said to be of independent of load on the motor. So this speed control is independent of load on the shaft of the motor, as we are only playing with the shunt branch. And for the non-polar DC shunt motor, the maximum speed control range can be raised to 2:1. So generally we employ the interposes to overcome the problems of commutation. So for the non-interpolar DC shunt motor, the maximum speed range can be raised by 2:1 ratio, and for the interpolar DC shunt motor, the speeds can be achieved from maximum to minimum in the ratio of 6:1. So that means for the motor with DC shunt motor with interpoles, the speeds can be varied over a wide range above the normal speed. So now if we discuss about the armature control methods, again here we are having the three methods. So one is the armature resistance control, and other one is the shunted armature, and other one is the, as we say, it is the armature voltage control method. So in the let us first discuss the armature resistance control method. So this is the basic circuit diagram for your armature resistance control method. Here what we are doing is, just by varying the control resistance, I can able to vary the voltage across this armature. So let us suppose here I have applied some voltage V. Now there will be certain drop depending on the value of the resistance, there is the value of the controlling resistance. So as there is more drop, there will be the less voltage appearing across this armature terminals. And here your shunt current will remain constant, because I am playing only with the armature branch, rather I am playing with the shunt. So here in the field rheostat control, we have played with the shunt branch, that is a field winding branch, and here we are playing with the armature branch. Here I can able to increase or decrease the value of this resistance, thereby I can able to vary the armature, that is a voltage across the armature. So by increasing the value of this resistance, I can reduce the voltage appearing across this armature, and thereby I can decrease the speed, that is below normal speed only. And here this branch current remains independent, and this doesn't get anything affected, as we are playing only with the armature branch. And now if we move to the shunted armature control, so before understanding the shunted armature control, here the voltage across the armature depends on the load, it depends on the load as well as the controlling resistance. So in order to reduce the double dependency of the voltage across the armature, what I am doing is, I am connecting a shunted branch, a variable shunted branch across this armature. So by employing a shunt branch of a variable resistance across the armature, I can able to overcome the double dependency of the voltage across armature. So by having a resistance across this armature, I can able to overcome the change in the armature current, which is owing to change in the load torque, which is owing to change in the load torque. It will be less effective in changing the voltage across armature. So if just I am here reducing the double dependency, where in the armature resistance control, the voltage across the armature depends on the controlling resistance as well as on the load. But in the shunted armature control, I am reducing the change of the voltage across the armature by reducing the or by making less effective the change in the armature current owing to the load torque. So this is the shunted armature control. Now discussing about the armature voltage control. So in the armature voltage control, I will be having a separate voltage source connected across this field winding apart from the main connected voltage source across this armature. So here this armature voltage control method, what it does is, so here I won't be having this resistance in the armature voltage control method. So this is directly connected here. So these armature voltage control methods avoids the disadvantage of low efficiency and poor speed regulation. So as this method avoids the disadvantages of the poor speed regulation and low efficiency, this method is widely employed. And you can see here the variable voltage source, where the variable voltage can be provided using electronic rectifier, or it may be by using an adjustable voltage generator. So I can have an adjustable generator, voltage generator, which is nothing but we can say a watt Leonard system, which is having a motor generator set to provide the adjustable voltage. So to provide the adjustable voltage across this field winding, I can go for the electronic rectifier or the adjustable voltage generator, which is nothing but the watt Leonard system. And the advantage of using this armature voltage control is it has excellent starting characteristics. So it has excellent starting characteristics because you can increase the voltage of the generator bringing from zero. So you can increase the voltage of the adjustable voltage generator from zero to bring up the motor speed. So in order to bring the motor up to speed, you are just slowly increasing the voltage of the generator from zero value. So this increase in speed is comparatively more, because there will be less, for the less value of increase in voltage, you will find a greater value of increase in speed. So as you can gradually increase the voltage of generator from zero, you can increase the motor up to speed very smoothly. So you can find a good acceleration of this armature voltage control for the DC shunt motor. So if we discuss the advantages of the armature voltage control, as it is having excellent starting characteristics, it is employed in the modern elevator systems. So basically it is employed in the elevator systems, the paper machines, and you can say mine hoist and the steel rolling machines, etc. So this can be employed because of this excellent starting characteristics. And the other advantage is, so it has a very fine speed control. It has a very fine speed control in a whole range of the speed. It has a very good speed control in both directions, top and bottom. It has a very good speed control. So good speed control, and it also has good speed regulation. So upon application of load, there will be less change in the speed, and it is having a uniform acceleration. And the fourth thing is, it can provide you regenerative braking capacity. Regenerative braking capacity, I am not going to discuss what is this regenerative braking capacity. It is a very, it takes time to explain this. You can just Google what is regenerative braking system. So these are the advantages of this armature voltage control. And if we discuss the disadvantage is here across the armature, if I have the voltage more than the rated voltage, then there will be causing a damage to this armature. So generally the speed control is done below the base speed only. So below the base speed only you can able to vary the speed. The speed variation is possible only below the base speed because I cannot go beyond the rated voltage. So that means I can go only the voltages below the rated voltages to prevent any damage to the armature. And the other disadvantage is the cost arrangements. So the Ward Leonard system or the electronic rectifier includes a lot of cost. So the cost arrangement is more or intensive and the floor size should be required more. There is the other disadvantage. And you can say more disadvantages like it is having low efficiency at light loads and the drive speed is also very noisy. So these are the specific advantages and disadvantages of the armature voltage control. So this is all about the speed control of DC shunt motor. I hope you understood well. Please subscribe my channel. Thank you.